Hello, hello, hello to all my uniques out there. This is your favorite girl, Akudo. Welcome to your unique world. For today, our topic is lies. Lies upon lies upon lies. To all my returning subscribers, hello, welcome back. For those of you that are not part of my family, what are you waiting for? You watch all my videos, you might as well come join us. You see the red button that says subscribe? Click on that button. Wait for the notification bell. Click on that one too, so that you will be the first to see my videos once they drop. Now, let's jump right into it. I did a video on 10 tips how to get your man or your woman to fall in love with you. And I said the first two topics, be yourself, be yourself. Be who you are, don't be who you are not. And so many of you were like, woo, everybody was like, how can I be who I am? When I am who I am, they don't like me. When I'm who I am, they don't accept me. When I bring out who I am, nobody wants to be in a relationship with me. So Miss Unique, how can you tell me to be myself whenever I am myself, people don't want to date me? So what do I do? So I decided to come to you guys with, I'm going to do it part two. For today, we're going to talk about lies. When I say the word lies, what does it mean? I'm going to talk about the different kinds of lies that that there are. And then I'm going to talk about the common ones that we know about, types of lies. And then I'm going to talk about how to identify these lies, because these lies can be in different forms. It might be in white, black, it might be in different forms. And you will not know. Then the second video after this one, maybe I'll do that maybe 3 days or 4 days from now. I'm going to talk about now lies in relationship. Does it make a difference? Not telling you the truth, hiding a little bit from you, minimizing it, restructuring the story. Does it make a difference? And we're going to talk about it. That will be a whole different video. But today we're going to talk about lies, lies. Lies. All the different kinds of lies. That's what we're going to talk about today. Now, let's jump right into it. First of all, I'm going to go to Google and I'm going to get my definition of lies. Okay? Let's go to Google and find out what Google said about lies. The word lie. It says, a lie is an assertion that is believed to be false, typically used with the purpose of deceiving someone. A lie is an assertion that is believed to be false. You know it is not the truth. It's false. But is typically used with the purpose of deceiving someone. The practice of communicating lies is called lying. A person who communicates a lie is called a liar. All right? Come on, my units, come closer. Go grab a chair, grab your popcorn, grab something to drink, call your friend, call that friend that keeps lying to you, call that colleague that is always lying, tell them to come on, Miss Unique is on. Come on, let's talk about it. Come on, let's reason together, okay? If you have something to say, you're watching, put it there on the comment section. Let's talk about it, all right? So let me continue. He says, a lie is an assertion that is believed to be false. You already know it's not the truth, but you decide to still say it with one purpose, and that purpose is to deceive someone. A person that communicates in this manner is called a liar, and the process of communicating in this manner is called lying. Now that the definition is out of the way, there are several ways that we lie. So many of us think that some lies are bigger than the other and some lies are smaller than the others. Some of us will say, like little children, when my children were growing up, they'll say, I told a little lie. So they qualify the lie based on what they are lying about. Who drank the juice? I didn't drink the juice. And then finally, when you find out, why did you lie to me? No, mommy, I just lied a small lie, because they think that one is not a big lie. Do you understand? And then some of us, we say lying by omission. That means I told you, but I didn't tell you the whole truth. I told you some of it, but I omitted some parts. So there's some of us will say, oh, you lied by omission. Some of us will say, oh, that's a black lie. Black lie is like the worst of it all. Like it's a big thing you told. Like, you know, you like you cheated and then you lied about it. That's a black lie. You know, it's a huge one. You know, we classify these things based on how we feel. And some people also say what they call a white lie. A white lie is not like a black lie. It's a lie, but it's not that bad. It's not that damaging. You know, it's like, I lied and said that I was at the restaurant yesterday eating and having fun when I didn't really go. That's not hurting nobody. It's just a lie to make me feel good. That's not hurting anybody. And then we come to the question some of you asked me. So which group lies the most? Is it the men or the women? Some research, some people, some school of thought will tell you, if you put it in Google, you'll find it. Some people will say men lie more than the women. Why some other groups say women lie more than the men? Sister, brother, I don't know who lies the most. I don't know whether it's our brothers. I don't know whether it's our sisters. But what I know is that majority of us, we lie. And most of the time when we ask you, why are you lying? We give every excuse under the sun. And all those excuses at the end of the day does not help. Now, let's go to some of the reasons why we lie. We've talked about the definition. We've talked about so many things we call it. Some of us say it's white lie. Some say it's black lie. Some say it's small lie. Some say it's little lie. Some say it's big lie. Some say it's lying by omission. Several, but I haven't gotten to the types of lies. I'll talk about that later on. Now, I want us to talk about what are some of the reasons why we lie. My sister, my brother, what are some of the reasons? I want you to go back to when you were single. Or when you were married, or the last time you lied, why did you lie? The first reason that I noticed that people lie is because sometimes they feel they are trying to save face. They are ashamed. You caught them red-handed, or they feel like you will judge them. They are ashamed. So they make up these stories that didn't happen. They make up, fabricate these stories just to give you a lie instead of you trying to find out who really they are. The first reason why people do that is to save face. The second reason why they do that is sometimes to save their ego, to protect their ego. You know, when somebody is all that, and then you catch them in a compromised situation, they want to cover it up with a lie. Because how do I start explaining to you what happened and what didn't happen? That's the second reason I've noticed people lie. The third reason is to protect their image. Just like to protect their ego, to protect their image. If you're a well-known person, you are an influencer, you're somebody that is believed to be like this, and then you are found to be like this. So you now want to lie to cover up the difference, because how do you explain what they saw you do, or how do you explain what this part of you that they are seeing? So that is the reason why some people lie. Excuse me. And then some other people lie to avoid conflict. You know what? I don't want to go back and forth with you. So instead of me telling you the truth and me and you going back and forth, you know what is the, I will just make up a story for you to just carry your wahala and go. And let me carry my own wahala and go. You know, so sometimes people lie because they don't want conflict. They want to avoid conflict. Finally, some people lie to protect you. So I have had this one several times, but I did not, I lied because I didn't want to hurt your feelings. But bros, come closer. Sis, come closer. If you lie to protect them, they will finally find out. And when they find out, you will still hurt them. Now it will be hurt twice. Because not that you did that to them, you lied about it. Now they found out about it. That is double betrayal. Excuse me. That's double betrayal. Now they feel like you lied to me the first time it happened, and then I asked you, you lied to me the second time, and you then went ahead and did that. So it doesn't protect nobody. So the reason why I'm not saying that this reason is, oh, it's good, go out there and lie. No, I'm just trying to explore with you. You know, we are reasoning together, we are coming together, we are trying to think about, okay, why do people do this? Why do we do this? Most of the time, number one, they lie to protect themselves, to save their image. Number three, they save to save their ego. Number four, to save their partner, to protect their partners. Number five, you know, to send their email to say, you know what, I can't do this. And then to avoid conflict. They don't want to get in trouble. And sometimes they also lie because they don't want to get in trouble. Maybe they did something and now they have been caught, and the consequences of that thing will maybe take them to the jail, or take them, or maybe the consequences might be their wives leaving, or their husbands leaving, or their children despising them. So they say, you know what, I might as well lie. At least let me lie and cover it up, and you know, that way. But at the end of the day, my sisters and my brothers, these things always have a way of coming out. So you have actually hurt the people that you love the most, and then you lied about it. And then my unique, some of you were like, what if I tell the truth and they leave me? What if I tell the truth and they leave me? My sister, my brother, I always tell you guys, nobody is perfect. If your partner is making you feel like he is perfect or she is perfect, that you can't be honest with him or her, my sister, you have to sit down with him or her and have a heart-to-heart discussion. We all make mistakes. We are all work in progress. I make mistake, you make mistake. I should be able to come to you and tell you my mistakes and tell you, hey, I messed up today. Look at what I did. Look at, you might be mad, you might be upset, you might tell me, Akudo, you shouldn't have done that. You knew better. Why would you do that? But it's better that me and you talk about that mistake and we get over it than I come to you and lie. And then tomorrow, 3 days, 5 days, 10 years, 15 years after, you find out the truth, and then you now begin to question everything that we had. Did I even love you? When I said I love you, was it the truth or was it a lie? When I said I went to Nigeria to go see my parents, did I actually go or was it a lie? You see, you now begin to, and you know the effect, or how would I say, the side effect of lying is that it makes people distrust you. It makes people, they don't trust you. They don't want to deal with you because they know you are a liar. Everything that comes out of your mouth is a lie. My sister, my brother, come closer. Let me tell you something. There are people that I coach and there are people that I talk to. Hey, Chineke, every word that comes out of their mouth is a lie. They will even make up stories that never happened just to keep talking. Do you know there are people like that? They will just sit down, make up story. Oh, guess what? I saw Akudo yesterday at the mall. Oh, we were laughing. Even Akudo took me to the store and she bought me some clothes and then we left. They did not see Akudo yesterday. They have not even spoken to Akudo this whole year. They have not even seen Akudo anywhere. And yet they are telling you they were with that. And you are like, oh, sister Mureni, why your cool temper, sister? Bros, cool temper. They will fabricate stories that never happened. And there are people like that. I'm going to break down the different kinds of lies so that you can be able to identify when that man, when that woman is lying to you. You will be able to know. Okay? If you listen real good, my mother said, when you keep quiet and sit at a corner and keep watching, people will show you their true self. My mom, Joy, she was 100% right. My mom told me, don't be in a hurry. Just take your time, be quiet, sit in your corner and be sipping your tea. Trust me, sister. Trust me, brother. Give people enough time. They will show you their true self. And remember, when they show you who they are, believe them. Don't make excuses for them. Oh, he lied to me because maybe he was angry. Oh, he lied to me because he was trying to protect me. Oh, he lied. No, he lied. He lied. She lied. She lied. Don't make excuses for them. And there are people that, oh my goodness, everything that come out of their mouth, like I said in that video, it's a lie. They say good morning to you, open the window, open, look, make sure it's money before you say good morning back to them. If they tell you good afternoon, open the door, look, oh, okay, before they lie for everything. I don't know whether you know people like that. Everything that come out of their mouth is a lie. They will tell you stories that never happened. They will tell you discussions they had with people that they have not spoken to. They will lie about everything. They will lie about their husbands. They will lie about their children. They will lie with their children. They will lie. There was a story. A lady called me. Let me tell you guys the story. A lady called me. She told me, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. My past has come to haunt me. My past. I said, what do you mean by your past came to haunt you? She said that she was married. She was either in South Dakota or something like that. I think it's South Dakota. She told me she was married to a guy over there. The guy was very abusive. She didn't like the marriage, but she had five children. Five children. My uniques, are you listening? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let me count it in Igbo. Otu, abo, ato, ano, ise. Let me count it in Spanish. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco. Five children. Four boys and a girl. She had it, but the relationship was abusive, was toxic, so she couldn't do it anymore. She left the marriage. She got married at 19. So she left the marriage. And then she moved over to Washington. And she stayed in Washington, went back to school, did everything. She is good now and met this guy who is a doctor in a hospital where she works. And she started dating this guy. According to her, they love each other. But this is her past. She couldn't tell the man that she was married with five children. And I'm like, okay, keep telling, I'm listening, keep going. She said she couldn't tell the man because that was her past. She did not require the man to tell her all his past dealings with women. So she felt that they should start afresh on a clean slate. So she did not tell the man she was married before or had children before. And she got married to this new man. Now they are married. They have two children together. So I don't know what happened. You know the way this world has a way of, things have a way of coming back. Things you think you have pushed down, they have a way of coming back to you. So I don't know how she said she had her husband moved to Washington or they came to Washington for a field trip. I don't know how the story happened, but she said that she met her husband and her husband recognized her. Because she left and she didn't tell anybody where she went. And this has been years, like 10 years after. So when her husband saw her children are grown, her husband saw her and her husband called her name. She turned around and saw her husband and was trying to pretend like, how do I know you? Have I met you before? And the man said, Akudo, for example, let me use my name, Akudo. What's going on? You know, Akudo this, Akudo that. So when the husband kept talking to her, she was acting like she didn't know what the husband was talking about. She didn't know, oh, please, you're disturbing me. I need to leave. She left. But she's telling me that now her husband traced her, is trying to come and tell her new husband. Her children want to meet her, but these people are her past. And I'm looking at her like, Nim, are you crazy? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Otu, abo, ato, ano, ise. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro. You think you can forget five children? You think you can forget five children? What do you expect this, my new brother, to do? This man is looking at you now thinking, tomorrow, if something happens, are you also going to forget these two that you and him share together? Sis, this doesn't happen. You have to tell him. You have to let your new husband know this is your... You made a mistake, you didn't tell him. But now that you are here, we have to deal with it. There's nothing I can do for you. I don't know what you want me to do. You want me to tell you forget your five children? You want me to tell you to not have a relationship with your children? My sisters, I use this story to explain to you guys. People can go to any extent to lie. To lie to cover up things. You can't forget five children and pretend like they never happened. Yes, they did. These are five living human beings. You can't pretend like they don't exist. Yes, they do. And it is high time you face whatever is in front of you, face it head on. So like I was saying, so many of us lie. We lie when it is necessary. We lie when it is not necessary. We lie when we need to do it, when we don't need to do it. We just lie. I always say that these kind of people, I call them compulsive liars. I've met a couple of people like that. Everything that comes out of their mouth is a lie. Everything. The story they tell you is a lie. And when you get that, I'm going to deal with this next week. When you get into relationship and you started a relationship with a lie. Ngwa, come. Sister, come closer. My bros, come closer. Now listen. Keep those ears open. No relationship will work when it is founded on lies. Let me say it again. No relationship or marriage will work when it is founded on lies. You are lying to each other. You are lying. You are omitting. I will give you the 7 different types of lies. You are lying. You are lying. What do you think will happen, my sister? What do you think will happen in this marriage? You think you can lie and nobody will find out? You think you can lie to him and he thinks he can lie to you, and then you think it will not come out later on to bite you guys? Honey, relationships are not based on lies. And then the lady was telling me, but my new husband, if he loves me, he should understand this, my past. I said, come on, come off it, my sister. What are you talking about? Don't ask people to do what you cannot do for your own self. Let me say that again. Don't always ask people to do for you what you cannot do for yourself. You know that if the reverse was the case, you will not do it. So why do you want somebody else to do it for you? You're telling me that your new husband should understand that you didn't tell him because that was your past. How can 5 children living be your past? They are living. They are alive. How can they be your past? You can tell him your past was you had a marriage. Your past was you had children. But your children are alive. And they are doing well. You left the marriage because he was abusive. You have the right to do that, to say that. But you cannot deny that they never existed. And you think, oh, but it doesn't matter. It was just a small lie. No, honey, bam, bam, bam. It's not a small lie. That was a huge one. That was in the kukuya, big one. No. My sister, my brother, I'm going to now go into the 7 types of lies. How you will identify he is lying to you. How you will identify she is lying to you, because there are several of them, and most of the time we dump everything into one. Oh, lie, everybody lie. No, there are different kinds of lies. Okay, now I want us to go to the first one. The first one says error. Lying by error, that is lying by mistake. Number one, error lie, that is lying by mistake. Me accidentally like. When my children were young, when they do something and you ask them, come here, who did that? They say, mommy, it's not me. Then when you do your little investigation and you find that, and then you call them, you say, I thought you said it was you. Mommy, I'm sorry, it was a mistake. Which one was a mistake? Was it when you were telling the lie? Or after you finish telling the lies. So that's the first one. Lying by mistake. Lying accidentally. Maybe you wanted to say, I'm coming, and you said, I'm going. Maybe you wanted to say, I'm going to give you $100. And accidentally you said, I'm going to give you $200. It's a lie, but it's a lie by error. It's a lie by mistake. That's number one. Number two is omission. Omission means leaving some relevant parts out. The story is, we went to that nightclub. We went to that nightclub. I ate some food. I drank some wine. And then I came home. But because I know if I tell you I went to that place, I went to that nightclub, you wouldn't want me in a nightclub. So I'll say, oh, I went out with my friends and we ate, we drank, and we came home. You see how I omitted the nightclub? That one was conveniently omitted. That is lying by omission. Lying by omission is when you lie, you tell the story, but you leave the relevant part out of it. You know, some of us, we mothers, sometimes we do it, you leave the relevant part. You went to the mall. You went to the mall and you went and bought those shoes. But you know that if you bring those shoes back into that house, your husband will say, Habana, my sister, are you a shoe industry? Every day you go to the mall, you buy shoes. Take it easy now. So what you do is when you come back, they ask you, oh, did you buy anything from the mall? You say, oh, no, I didn't buy. I just stopped at Kroger and bought me some groceries. You bring in the groceries, but the shoes you bought It's in the boot of your car in the garage. It's in the boot of your car in the garage because that is lying by your mission. You gave all the information. You went to the mall. You did sightseeing. You saw so many beautiful things. Then you stopped at Kroger and bought some grocery. But the part of buying the shoes was entirely eliminated. And you keep those shoes in the boot of your car in the garage until you see that man go to work. Then you tiptoe. Even you don't let your children see it because those children, you know, they are blabber mouths. They'll go there. So what you do is you leave the shoes in the boot. And then when you notice your children are distracted, they are playing, you tiptoe downstairs and go get your shoes and run into your closet and dump it in there. So that when you put it on Sunday or your girl, your husband say, did you buy a new shoe? Mm-mm. I've had this for a long time. Sisters, you know what I'm talking about. Sisters, you know what I'm talking about. Yes, so that is lying by your mission. You are lying. You're giving all the information, but you're eliminating the relevant ones that you don't want to give out there. That is number two, lying by your mission. Number three says restructuring lying. That is when you take the whole story. You know how you restructure something? You take the whole story like this, and then you restructure it to be like this. This is where you take the whole story and change it into something else. Let me give you an example. Let's say you went out with your friends, and you were supposed to be out for maybe 2 hours, and then come in and maybe help cook dinner or whatever. And you were there, you know, girls or men, you were there having fun with your men friends and drinking and laughing and, you know, having fun, and you forgot. Now you have, instead of 2 hours, you have stayed, let's say, 6 hours. Now dinner is late. So you stop at McDonald's and grab something for your children. You come home and then they ask you, honey, where have you been? Oh, you don't know what happened today. You know, on my way, my car, my tires busted. I had to stop begging for somebody to help me change my tires. You see, you restructured the whole story. And then, and now the man is saying, oh my God, thank God. Oh, thank God you saw somebody to help you. You have taken the whole story and restructured it into a different story that now they are saying, child, sorry, oh, you have suffered my wife. Oh, you have suffered my husband. Some men too, let's say, how do I say, maybe the men, they told their wives they're going to hang out with their friends and they stayed a little bit too long. Now they are coming back and they're saying, oh, you don't even know. Our friend was just had a nervous breakdown. We were there consoling him. Oh, this man has suffered. They will take this story and restructure it into something. That is the third type of lie. Remember, the first one is lying by error, lying by omission, lying by restructuring the whole story. Restructuring lying, that is changing the whole story into something that benefits you. That's number three. And then number four, say denial lie. Denial lie is the one you catch them like this, red-handed, and they're still saying it never happened. It never, with your two, even you be asking yourself, hey, are you sure I am not blind? Because you saw them like this, like croco, like this, you saw them. And they're telling you, me? That wasn't me. And you're saying, ah, is that not you, Akudo? Oh, no, that's not me. You know, I used to have a twin, but she died. These people, they have what I call PhD in lying. They will tell you, oh, their mom had twins. They are twins. That's, oh, that the twin died. They will make up, and that's my cousin that looks like me. When you catch them red-handed, they will still find a way. That is total denial. Whatever you say, whatever you do, get a camera, they will say it's not them. Get a picture, they will say it's photoshopped. Everything you say, lies. They don't believe you. They will lie their way, lie their pants off. They will lie and deny. No matter what you say, you will be there screaming, turning blue, turning red, and they're looking at you. If you're lying, look at me and say it is not true. They will look right into your eyes and say, it's not true. That is lying by denial. No matter what, those people, that's number four. They lie by denial. They will never accept is the truth. And then number five is minimization. That's another kind of lie. This is the one we call small lies. They take the whole story and minimize it. They water it down. They know that if they tell you exactly what happened, you will be upset. So what they do is they minimize it. They reduce it to where they think you will be able to accept the lie. You know, what example will I give with that one? They might maybe, you caught them maybe cheating or something, and then they will switch it around and say, oh, I wasn't cheating. The man was doing this. They will find a way. Oh, I went for a work assignment. Oh, they will find a way to change the whole story and minimize it where you yourself will even be saying, oh, really? If it's how it happened, then it's not a big deal. If that's how it happened, then it's not a big deal. I'll let it slide. It's not a big deal. They will minimize it to the lowest. That's like the fifth type of lie. And then the sixth type of lie is the one I call the exaggeration. These people, when they tell you a story like this, you will be flying. Lies. From beginning to end, lies. They can exaggerate their story. Sometimes when things happen, you were there when those things happened. But when you hear them tell this story, you'll be asking yourself, hold on, this thing she's saying now, is it not what happened yesterday? I was there. That's not how it happened. Hey, in my country, when we were young, my mother would say, eat it, nuti yo se, tia crafish, gea mayo into a soup. That is, they will lie, eh? They will put this. let me tell you guys a story. There was one of my cousins. He came to me. Oh, do you know what happened? Told me this whole story of everything that happened from beginning to end. And I'm like, really? Were you there? He said he was there. He was there. He saw that he was sitting down like this and this whole thing was happening in front of him. And he was like, really? Oh, I must tell Akudo this thing. I said, okay. So I said that there was somebody I called. I called the person's name. I said, was the person there? Because the person, I had already called that person and asked him, did you go? And that person told me no. Nobody went. Nobody went from my family. Nobody went. So we were not there. I said, okay. So this, my cousin now came telling me how he was there, how he saw everything. He was in front like this, sitting down and watching everything. So I now said, let me find out if he's lying. I said, so I called my other cousin. I said, wasn't that my cousin there? He said, oh, my cousin, look at where he's sitting. And my cousin was sitting here. Two of them were watching it. And I started laughing. He said, what's funny? I said, because you are lying. You are lying. My cousin already told me this morning, 30 minutes before I spoke to you, that he was not there. So how did you go sit with my cousin? And he said he wasn't there. And nobody from my family went there. He said, hey, man, I just wanted to entertain you. The people that exaggerate, they exaggerate to entertain you. When they give you 5 naira, they tell the whole world they gave you 5 million. When they give you a plate of food, they tell the whole world they packed food and brought to your house. When they give you a shirt, they will tell the whole world they took you shopping. Because it's all about their ego. It's all about showing off like they have arrived. It's all about, oh, I'm a giver. I give too much. So because of that, they lie and lie and everything, they make it bigger than necessary. Excuse me. They make everything bigger than necessary because they want to impress themselves. They want to impress you. They want to impress whoever is listening. When they have $1 in their pocket, this is for men, that, especially for my brothers, who wants to maybe chike a woman or chase a woman. They want to make themselves bigger than they are not. Huh? You see that car over there? I have about 7 of them. The car doesn't belong to them. It's their friend's car. Or maybe a car they lease. Oh, you know, I have 3-story building like this, about 7 of them in town. I have this. I have me. They want to tell stories that are not real. They want to blow everything out of proportion. That's a lie. Most people think, oh, but it's not a lie now. He's just exaggerating. No, my sister. No, my brother. That's a lie. We have talked about lie by error. We have talked about lie by omission. We have talked about lie by restructuring. We have talked about lie by denial. Excuse me. We have talked about minimization. You minimize the lie. We have talked about exaggeration. You make everything bigger than it's supposed to be. And finally, the last one is lying by fabrication. This is the one that gets me. My sister, brother, come closer. Majority of us fall into this. And if you are a woman or a man that is in this category of fabrication, my sister, before you walk a much, because remove your hands. This is not good. These sisters or these brothers, some of them I know, they can lie. And because they lie so much, you can't trust anything that come out of their mouth. They become the boy that cried wolf, wolf. Because every time they talk, it is made up, fabricated, minimized, error, denial, lies. So now, you don't trust whatever that comes out of their mouth. Whatever they say, you don't trust. Fabrication is when they make up stories that never happened. And we won't at all. They sit down and they make up the stories. You see, one thing that scares me with people that fabricate things is that they are very smart. I'm being honest with you. They come up with stories they will tell you, my sister, you will be crying blood. You'll be crying. Say, child, your sister has suffered. Child, my sister has suffered the lies. From beginning to end, lies. They will make up story even with their own health. They will tell you that something is wrong with them when nothing is wrong with them. They will make up story even with their own money. Oh my goodness, they make up story for fabricate. You know how you start something from the scratch? They start it from the scratch and then they build up this whole mountain of lies. Like build a house with cards, all lies. That is the seventh kind of lie, fabrication. For example, let us say you went to the mall. And like I used the same story before, I went to the mall, I bought some shoes, I went to the food court, I ate, and then I stopped at Kroger, I did some grocery, and I came home. I lied by omission, I didn't put that I bought shoes. I lied by error, instead of saying I went by 4 o'clock, I said I went by 6 o'clock. That's by error. Then I restructured the story by saying I did not go to the mall because nobody wants me to be in the mall. So I lied and said, I went to a shopping plaza. You see, but there is an atom of truth. Even though I'm changing, I'm minimizing, I'm trying to restructure, I'm trying to make an error, I'm trying to omit some, but at least the truth is I went out today. The truth is that I bought shoes today. The truth is that I ate at the food court. The truth is that I stopped at Kroger. The truth is that I bought some grocery. The final truth is that I came home. That I omitted some part of this story and left some part, exaggerated some part. Instead of saying I bought shoes, I said I bought clothes for my children to make it look more real and whatever. They are all lies. But now, fabrication is when six of these things never happened. You were in your room, sleeping on your bed, watching TV, and then picks up the phone.
Try.
Picks up the phone and calls your sister or calls your brother or calls your mom or call your auntie or your colleague. You just call these people. They did not call you. They did not call you. They did not ask you any question. At least with the other ones, somebody asked you, where did you go today? So you now started your lie by omission, lie by error, lie by denial, restructuring, minimizing, exaggerating. Now you are not trying to do what? Remember the reason. Either protect yourself, protect your image. You don't want to avoid, you want to avoid conflict. You don't want to start trouble. You don't want, that's why you're doing, not an excuse. Listen to me, it's not an excuse to lie. But like I said before, that's it. But fabrication means you are on your bed. In your nightgown. Nobody called you. Nobody asked you any question. You picked up your phone by yourself. You picked up your phone, dialed your sister, dialed your brother, dialed your cousin, your husband, your wife, your niece, your nephew, whoever you dialed, and then start telling them, guess what? You will not believe it, Akudo. Right now, I just landed in Paris. Oh my God, oh, Paris is so beautiful. You know, I flew in last night and what do you want me to buy for you for a souvenir? Well, I'll get you some t-shirts and oh my God. Hold on a second, Akudo, hold on a second. Hey, get the food over here. Yes, I want to get the fish and the Alfredo chicken, okay? Yeah, yes, Akudo. Oh, I was just talking to the waiter to get me my food. It is so beautiful. Hey, my sister, this never happened though. She's in her bed though. In her bedroom. Oh. Never happened. That's the ones that scare me. Those are the ones that scare me. These people that just make up stories. Nobody asked you. Nobody is inquiring from you. Nobody is investigating you. People are in their homes resting and you're taking your phone or you're going to go visit them and then create this lie and give it to them. And just create this big old story about what you're going through or what happened to you or where you are. Never happened. Chineke me, my sister, why? My brother, why? What do you gain? The only answer that I have come to is low self-esteem. You want so much to be accepted that you have to go out of your way to make up stories just to give yourself a sense of belonging. Be yourself, my sister. Go watch my video on I Am Enough. Be yourself. That's why I told you guys on that video, 10 tips how to get your man or woman to fall in love with you. Be yourself. Nobody wants to love a liar. Nobody wants to love you when they can't trust what is coming out of your mouth. Nobody wants to love you when all you do is go from one place to the other lying. Everybody in the community knows you as a liar. When they say, oh, guess what? Akudo told me, they say, which Akudo? Hey, which Akudo told you, my sister? Oh, you know Akudo and Akudo hit him. Hey, be kokwe. Did you check whether it's what really happened? You know that girl can lie. That's not a good report. My brother, it's not a good report. When you say, oh, Imano, let me use my husband as an example. Oh, Imano, Nancy was the one that told me. Which Nancy? Nancy, they hit him. Ah, my brother, you better be sure before you put yourself in trouble. You know, Nancy never tells the truth. That's not a good reputation. That's why I wanted, this is a unique word. Lies, lies, and lies. Why do we lie so much? Be who you are. And then some of you are saying, but when I'm who I am, people don't like you. My sister, come closer. That's why I wanted to do this video. Now that you lied and they love the new you, for how long are you going to keep up the lies? For how long are you going to keep up the lies? So what happens when the lies have been discovered? So what happens? You told him, oh, I've had women, you know, they are getting, or even men, they are getting married and they will lie and say things they are from. There was this guy that wanted to, he was dating this girl. And they have dated like for a year. But every time he would tell the girl, you know, I don't want to take you home because I don't want to take you to my family unless I'm serious, because I only take serious people to my family and stuff like that. So finally, when the girl agreed, they said, okay, until we're serious. Now they've dated a year, they are serious. The girl now insisted, why don't you take me to go meet your family? So he took the girl to his family and showed the girl, oh, guess what? My mom and my dad, they are out. They traveled to Hawaii. They are not home. So, but this is our house. You know, show the girl the house. This is our house. This is where we live. You know, but I don't have the key because I don't live here anymore. I just come to visit. But this is my house. So the girl was like, wow, your house is big, you know. And you know women are like, okay. So she left. So you know women, we can be nosy sometimes. You know, we can be very nosy. So after about a week or two, the girl now decided, you know, took some of the things, you know, like maybe it was the boy's birthday. He bought stuff and then took to the address. You know, women, he wanted to go show, you know, give the boy's family and say, oh, this is for his birthday, you know, so that the mother-in-law, the new mother-in-law, will see that she is a giver or whatever, I don't know. So she said she got to the house, you know, and knocked and, you know, rang the bell, and this lady opened the door. She said, hey, how are you guys doing? The lady said, yes, how can I help you? He said, I'm looking for this. He called the boy's name. And the woman was like, oh, no, we don't have anybody here. This is the household of so-so-so. For example, this is a hidden resident. Who is the person you're looking for? Oh, I'm looking for, he called the boy's name again. And the boy's last name, the woman said, never heard of the name. He said, okay, maybe the man that owns the house, do you live here? The woman said, this is my house. I live here with my husband and two children. I don't know who you're talking about. And the girl was like, okay, hold on a second. The girl brought up her phone, brought the picture and showed the woman, said, this, your son. The woman said, I've never met that person before. And the girl was, I'm so sorry. So the girl was like, what? So the girl left and started calling the boy, well, you lied to me, blah, 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 blah. The boy was like, why would you go there? My parents don't live there anymore. Your parents don't live there anymore in two. They moved in two. They moved in 2 weeks, you know, and then the girl said, oh, no, unique, I can't, this is a lie, he lies all the time, blah, blah. You know, so at the end of the day, my sister, how is it working for you? Lying because you think, oh, I don't want to hurt the person. They will still find that and it's still going to hurt them. So then what next? My sister, let us try to be who we are. It's either they love you or they don't. They either love you or they don't. They either accept you or they don't. But it's better you put your foot out there and tell them who you are. This is me. This is who I am. It's either you like or you don't. It's okay with me. But don't go be who you are not. Don't go lying by error. Don't go lying by exaggeration. Don't go lying by fabrication. Don't go lying by minimizing stuff. Don't go lying by omission. Eliminate, or don't go lying by restructuring the truth. It does not help, my sister. That's your unique word for the week. It does not help. Tell the truth. Yes, I know your past is your past. I don't want you to carry your past into your new relationship, especially the baggages. But you still have to tell that brother that you were married before and you had 5 children. Like the story I told you before. You still have to tell that sister, my brother, that you were married before and you had 2 children. You cannot say, oh, it doesn't matter, it's my past. Children are not your past. They are your future. They are your present. They are here. They're not going nowhere. They are here. They are growing. They are getting bigger. They are getting better. That's your legacy. You can't deny your children. Some of us, we are willing to deny our children just to lie. We are willing to deny who we are. I have seen girls deny their parents. Oh, Akudo, is that your mom? Oh, I've never seen that woman before. I don't know. Oh, some people that time when we were younger, they would say, oh, that woman, oh, that's our housemaid. That's our cook in our house. And that's their mom. Because they have built a world of lies around them. They want to project who they are not. They want to say they come from this wealthy family where their father is an international businessman and their mother is an international businesswoman. So they have cooks and stewards and chefs all over the house. So when their mom now come to school to visit them, or come, you know, in Nigeria, we have dormitories. We live in school, in high school. Here, you guys go daily. In Nigeria, we live in high school. So when their parents come to the hostel to visit them and their parents didn't come with the Lexus and all this rich car, they are hiding. They don't want you to see their parents. Some of the time they will go to their parents, take whatever the woman brought and tell her to leave. They have assignment because they don't want their friends to see their parents. Some of us are ashamed of our children. We don't want, your child doesn't look like every other child that you think. Your child is not as pretty as you want her to be, or she doesn't dress the way you want her to dress, or you think she's not as intelligent as the other child, so now you want to pretend like she doesn't exist. That's a lie, my sister. That's a lie, my brother. You cannot, even if that child does not look the part, is not up to what you want, she is still a human being. He is still your child. Some of us deny our husbands. Oh, you married him, oh. You and him live in the same house, oh. You guys have children, oh. But when you are outside and your friends or your colleagues say, oh, is that your husband? That's my neighbor. He dropped me. That's the father of your children. And you're denying him because maybe he doesn't look the part. But you married him. That's what is confusing me. If he didn't look what you wanted, why did you marry him? You should have left him alone. Some other people would have loved him the way he is. Or some other people would have loved her the way she is. Don't go marry her. And now you think, oh, she doesn't look pretty anymore. Since she had those children, nothing is standing anymore. She's fat now. So she doesn't meet up. Now you want to, is that your wife? No. That's the lady. That's my cleaning lady. My sister, my brother. Fabrication, exaggeration, minimizing, restructuring, omission. Error. These are all lies. These are all lies. And finally, denial. That's the seven types of lies. Be very careful, my sister. Be very careful, my brother. I brought you these things today so that you can be able, as you are sitting down there dating that man, as you're sitting down there trying to be engaged to that man, as you're sitting down there trying to be engaged to that woman, as you're sitting down there trying to prepare for that marriage with that woman, open your eyes, shine your eyes. Know who is lying to you. You can now identify them. You can identify, number one, lying by error, by mistake. You can identify lying by omission when they leave relevant parts of the story. Lying by restructuring, when they restructure the whole story, you, Papa, will not recognize the story. And yet you were present when it happened. But you will not recognize it. They have restructured the whole thing. Lying by denial. Even when you catch them red-handed, again, you're wasting your time. It's not true. I saw you, Ashi. You didn't see me. It wasn't me. It was my twin sister. It is you. No, never. It's not me. It's my cousin. Lying by denial. Number four. Number five, lying by minimization. They minimize everything where they make a big deal into nothing. They take the whole mountain and make it into an anthill. And they, oh, they will reduce it, water it down. But it's still a lie. Number six, lying by exaggeration. They blow everything out of proportion. Maybe they saw Akudo outside and Akudo gave them a hug. They'll come and say, hey, Akudo even took me to a hotel. If you see what we did today, all lies. And then finally, lying by fabrication. It never happened. And they will forge this whole story. Dress it very nicely. Put a hat on it. Give it a very good haircut. Put some makeup on it. Put some tie for the men. Ha! Dress a child this lie like this. And if you see it, you say, good afternoon, sir. Lies. From the hair to the shoe. All fabricated. Not true. They would dress up this lie, Give the lie a dress, a pant, a shoe. Even give the lie a house and a car with a car key. If you see this lie, fabricated lie, he gonna say a good afternoon, good night, good evening, sir. All correct, madam. It never happened, though. Do not be deceived. Bible says, do not be deceived, for God is not mocked. Whatsoever a man sow, that you shall also reap. Let us be careful. When you claim, remember what the Bible says about love. Love does not count error. Love is kind. Love is patient. Love does not go around lying to each other. Love is not rude. Love is not boastful. When you say you love somebody, my sister, my brother, being honest, how can you say, I don't want to tell that I was married and had five children, that it was your past? Hey! This one is a little bit higher than the other ones. Take it easy now. Don't deny who you are just to get what you want. Some of us, we lie, we cheat, we do anything just to get what we want. My sister, my brother, that is not the way. Lying will not get you anywhere. It doesn't get you far. And next week, the next video, I'm going to talk about lying in relationship. What are the benefits? What are the disadvantages? It destroys marriages. It destroys relationships. When you lie to your children, you keep lying and lying, and they grow up to find out it's a lie, you will become their worst enemy, because now they don't trust nothing that comes out of your mouth. You lie to your spouse. You lie to your in-laws. You lie to your friends. You lie to your colleagues. You lie to your business partners. You lie in church. Everywhere you go, you lie. Hey, my sister, my brother, how will we trust you if nothing that comes out of your mouth, even good morning, is a lie? Because you said good morning when it was in the night. How do we trust you? How do we trust you, my brother? Take it easy. I'm not here because some statistics will say men lie more, women lie more. I'm not talking about who lies more or who doesn't lie more. I'm just saying, let us be watchful. Lies, different kinds of lies. Remember what the definition said. It is an assertion that is purposely created to deceive somebody. Lies is just created purposely. It's not by accident. It's purposely planned to deceive somebody. And you know, when a person communicates like this, that person is called a liar. And this process of communication is called lying. Remember what the definition said. Lies, lies, lies. My sister, my brother, come closer. Let's come closer. Now, let us talk. We are not perfect. We are all work in progress. We are all going towards perfection. But the Bible says that God's grace is sufficient for us. You can't do it by yourself. It's not her, you know me. I cannot, Jimmy here, I will never lie. Hey, I've mastered it, I can't lie. It's a lie, yo. It is a lie. We all need help. We all lie one way or the other. We all exaggerate stories one way or the other, either to make it sweeter, either to make it more fun, so that people will laugh, so we add also a little bit of salt, a little bit of pepper, and then we put some salad dressing on top of it, and then we begin to eat our lies. Some of us, we turn our lies into a very good jollof rice, put some fresh fish, put some sauteed vegetable, and then serve it and be eating our lies. We are not perfect. We are work in progress. But remember, the Bible says that God's grace is sufficient for us. You can't do it by yourself. Bible says it's not of he that willeth, it's not of he that runneth, it's of he that showeth mercy. It's not by your might, it's not by your power, it's by God's spirit, it's by God's grace. You have to commit it unto the Lord. It is a daily thing. The Bible says every day, work out your salvation. Work out your salvation. God will help us. God will help us, but relationship that is based on lies, my sister, my brother, be equal. If you are planning on getting married, or you're already married, or you are in the process of getting a new relationship, Biko, my sister, my brother, a relationship that is based on lies will come crumbling before you. By the time you know it, that house you have built with cats of life, every one of them will start falling apart, and you watch yourself crumble. My sister, my brother, let us strive. Let us strive to be honest to the people we love. Let us try to be truthful to the people. There was something I told you guys when I got married newly and I came to America. Nelson woke me up and told me 5 things that is a no-no for him. Boundaries. The first thing that was in that boundary was, he doesn't want lies. He said, I don't care what you do. I don't care what you go outside there and do. Tell me the truth, Akudo. Tell me the truth. I will be in a better position to defend you, protect you, be on your side if I know the truth. I can deal with the truth. Because that way, when people come at you, I say, don't worry about it. I know the truth. Don't worry. That's my wife. I know the truth. But when you don't tell me the truth and I go out there defending you only to find out that you lied to me, do you know how it makes me feel? I will look stupid. I will look dumb. I will look like, what is wrong with this man? Please, that's a no-no. That's one of his boundaries. Be honest to each other. Stop lying to each other just to be married. Stop lying to each other just to have a relationship. Those lies, my sister, my brother, they will catch up with you. And when they catch up with you, the same man that told you to lie for him will be the same man that will tell you you are a liar. That same woman that told you, bros, lie for me, is the same woman that will look at your face and tell you you lie too much. Because already he has firsthand experience of how you can lie. Because you have already told him to lie for you. So he has firsthand experience of how you can lie. Be very careful, my sister. Until next time. Next time, we're going to talk about why do we lie in relationships? The effects of lying in relationships. Today, all we talked about is what is lies, how many types of, 7 types of lies, and why do we lie? Remember, we lie to protect image. We lie to protect ourselves. We lie to save our ego. We lie to avoid conflict. We lie because we don't want the other person's feeling to be hurt. We lie because sometimes it makes us feel good. Just to lie and, you know, make yourself who you are not, just to feel good. Those are the 6 reasons why we lie. Then we talked about the 7 types of lie. Lying by error, lying by omission, lying by restructuring, lying by denial, lying by minimization, lying by exaggeration, and lying by fabrication. That's where we're going to stop today. And next week, next video, we are going to talk about why do we lie in relationship? Is it beneficial or is it destroying our relationship? Remember to give us a thumbs up, share this video, and please subscribe to the channel. And once I'm done with this video, you can go to Roku. You know, we are now on TV. So you go to Roku, you look for Unique TV. Once you see Unique TV, you can go and you'll see this video, okay? I'm about to upload it right now to Roku, so you can go see Roku. So you can go see it, all right? I love you guys. Remember, you are beautifully and wonderfully made by God. That is why you are unique. Be kind to yourself and to each other, all right? Mwah! Love you guys. Bye-bye.